Hello friends, welcome to SQL Practical Questions series. So here is another interesting question where you need to write a query to print the given input string welcome as given below outputs. So this kind of questions will not help us in production or writing real-time scenarios, but this is one such question which help us to understand the concept of RONEM and few string manipulation functions like substring and rpad very clearly. So through a fun way of writing such a SQL, we'll be able to understand these concepts much better. Now let us start writing the SQL. So let us just start from select welcome from dual. It's just printing the welcome, but our requirement is we need to print this string in a multiple row. So we'll just use connect by level less than, suppose I am just printing for 10 rows. Okay. You can use any of the query to print the sequence related information what we discussed in the earlier videos here. So just for simplicity, I am just using the connect by level. So in this case, we don't want to print it for 10 rows. We need to print it for exactly the number of characters in the string. So instead of 10, let us use the length of the input string. Okay, welcome. So it will just print us 7 rows. Now let us just use RONEM pseudo column here, just for our understanding, because we are going to use this RONEM somewhere inside our string manipulation functions. And one more thing, since we are using the same string twice, let us just try to eliminate this by putting this string as an inline view here. Select welcome, we'll give S as alias for this from dual. So here we'll use S. So instead of this welcome also, we can just use. So by this way, we can just eliminate keeping the same string in two places. Okay, now we got it. Now let us start writing our first output. So now we are going to use the substring function. I'm just using substring of S comma RONEM comma 1. That means we are trying to print one character from RONEM position. Let us execute this query. As you can see, in the first row, it is printing the first character because in the first row, RONEM is 1. In the second row, it is printing E because in the second row, RONEM is 2. And the third parameter here says that how many characters we want to print. So in every row, we want to print one character from the RONEM's position. That's why we are getting the first output. Now let us try to execute get the second output. Exactly like a first output we want, but in a reverse order. So what we can do, instead of starting our search from the first part, now we can start from the right hand side. So what we can do, we can just make our second argument as a negative argument by multiplying it by minus 1. So I'm just putting second argument as RONEM into minus 1. Now if you can see, the output 1 is welcome in a same order, whereas the output is just a reverse order of the welcome 1. Now let us see how to get our third output. Okay. So I'm just copying the same thing. Let me just make it as like output 3. So now what we are going to do, instead of printing from the RONEM position, I'm just going to print from the first position of the string, but the number of character we are just going to specify using the RONEM. Now if you see, we are actually in the first line, we are printing one character, that is from first position, one character. In the second row, from first position, we are printing two character. So that input we are actually giving using the RONEM. Okay. Now let us see how to print our fourth output here. So I'm just copying the same thing, just making alias as output 4. So instead of 1, I'm just removing the second argument. I'm just removed. I just mentioned like the first argument as the string, whatever the welcome, and second argument as the RONEM. That means from RONEM's position, it will start the substring till the last. Let us execute it now. Now, if you see in the first row, we are getting all the complete string because we want from first character till end. The second row, we are substring the information from second character to the last character. So thereby just keep reducing. By this way, we are able to get the fourth output also. Now let us see how to print our fifth output. So for the fifth and sixth output, we just need to prefix the required number of spaces along with this information. By that way, we'll be able to get fifth output and the sixth output. Let us just try this. Now I'm just going to copy the same thing because it's exactly the same thing, but we are just going to put some space here. So now I'm just going to put, use the rpad function to put whatever, and I'm just padding here to give whatever the necessary space I want. And the second argument I'm saying row name. Third argument I'm saying space. Let us just make this as output 5. Now if you see, we are actually prefixing the required number of spaces so that the pyramid structure is getting printed in a different format. Now let us see how to get our sixth output. So I've just copied the same thing. Now I'm just going to use the whatever the say output 3. So because from the output 3, I'm just taking, because the same information, but I'm just going to prefix some row name. So in this case, we are just going to prefix length of s plus 1 minus row name. Okay. Now if you see, we are able to prefix the necessary spaces in front of the third output, and we are able to print in a different format of the pyramid. I'm sure you would have loved this particular SQL. I would suggest you write down this so that you'll be able to understand much better. I'm sure you'll be able to understand this. Okay, so let us not stop here. I just want to show you a few more examples so that you can try by yourself. Okay, let me show you one more example here. Instead of printing a welcome, you can just print a simple star in the same format like this. So whatever the format you want, you can print it here. So the only key learning here is that how we are going to use the row name, rpad functions and the substring functions. Okay, so you prefix the how much ever space you want, you suffix how much ever you want, you just insert some spaces in between so that it just displays whatever the format you want. Let us see one more example. So here I'm just trying to print the some other different format by combining the informations what I've showed you earlier. So in the second statement, we just printed an individual pyramids. Now you just concatenate all this information to print whatever the information, whatever the structure you want. Let us see one more example. So here I'm just trying to print the same thing, but in a bit different format so that you'll get a bit different way of output. Let us see one more example. So here is another query which just prints, it's again, the core concepts are exactly the same what we saw in the first query. But here it's all about how you are concatenating and printing the informations. Okay, let us see just one more query. So here is another query. I'm just trying to print a banner information saying welcome to class. So in first I'm printing some pyramid structure, then welcome to class string, followed by another set of pyramid structure. Let's see one more query. So here it's just printing a simple arrow pattern so that it's all just like a fun to learn. So I would suggest you try this. Maybe you might get a similar question in an, you definitely will not get this kind of question in an interview, but when you understand this better, you'll be able to answer anything related to row name with substrings and instring or rpad functions, lpad functions, all those things you can use. Let us just see one more simple query before we wind up this video. So here's another very simple thing, just to print the V format stars. I'm sure you'd have loved this video. If you've learned something new, please like this video, subscribe and stay tuned for new feature videos, interview questions, concept videos, tips and tricks. Thanks a lot for watching this video.